Warm and calm greetings to you, friends. Today we are exploring the game Shobu from Smirk and Laughter, a casual imprint from Smirk and Dagger. Shobu is Japanese for game, or match, and originates from the game Go. The similarities are only surface level between that game and this one, though, as you'll see in a moment. I'm very excited to show this one off, as it's competing for some very coveted space in the two-player abstract arena. Let's open up the box and see what awaits us inside. In the box is Shobu's simple rulebook, just 4 pages, one of which is a reference guide. Past that, we have the game's 4 boards, 2 in light and 2 in dark. A quick note on these, while I love the color differentiation here, what I really wanted was a better finish. The raw wood looks and feels nice, but would be leaps better with a coat of varnish. That might also help to protect them even further over time. In the side channel of the box, there's a piece of rope, which serves absolutely no game purpose, and 2 bags of the game's light and dark stones. These stones are absolutely fantastic, and I love that they're not identical to each other. It feels like Smirk and Laughter cleaned out their local home and garden store of landscaping rocks, and I love that. Let's set this up real quick, and I'll show you how to play. We start out with this perfectly elegant setup. Shobu has 4 game boards, separated by light and dark on the verticals, and opposing players' home boards on the horizontals. The black stone player goes first, and on your turn, you'll move 2 stones of your color in exactly the same fashion. You start with a passive move on one of your 2 home boards. You can move 1 stone up to 2 spaces in any direction. The passive move, the first move, is not allowed to come into contact with any stones, and jumping is never allowed in Shobu. You must then make the exact same move, only this move is allowed to come into contact with at most 1 stone. For an added layer of complexity, you have to make the aggressive move on the opposite color board. You are, however, allowed to make an aggressive move on one of your home boards. So an acceptable first move would be a black stone to move 2 spaces on the diagonal here, and then the aggressive move would be to move any of the black stones the same 2 spaces on the same diagonal on either of the light-colored boards. You might be asking yourself right now, what's with the rope? My friends, you're asking the same question I am. It's literally there just to separate the rows of home boards. Now, I'm not one to sneer at purely aesthetic components. Colt Express does this, only far worse, because you have to assemble those and they don't store easily in the box. Shobu's rope is pretty, simple, and while not at all necessary, is it wrong that I kinda like it? Along this same vein, there's a playmat for Shobu that resembles a Zen garden, and I'm seriously considering getting one, even though, yes, none of the game pieces would ever touch it. It's just for backdrop. For a game as gorgeous as this one is, I think it's perfectly fine to want to class up the visual even further, but as I always say, your mileage may vary. Anyway, back to the review. Pushing a stone off the game board is how you win the game, but it's not quite as easy as all that. Aggressive moves can't ever push more than 1 stone. So if white has 2 stones in a row like this, I can't push my black stone 1 space diagonal because it would result in pushing both of these white stones. Also, you're not allowed to push your own stone, so getting in your way is very, very much a thing you're going to run into in your early games until you learn how to avoid it. If your aggressive move is illegal, you can't make your initial passive move. You'll have to restart your whole turn. Winning Shobu happens when you clear any single board from all of your opponent's stones. Learning games of Shobu have been very quiet, very hilarious affairs as you start to make moves, realize you can't or don't want to do them, and then take them back, only to stumble into another illegal move, take it back, and begin again. Give yourself some patience with your first game. In my experience, it takes about halfway through your first game before it really clicks. The reason I'm advocating for you to stick with it is that underneath the hard candy shell here is a phenomenally elegant, masterfully amazing game that really evokes analogs like chess and Go. The surface level comparisons are obvious, but beyond the black and white and gridded boards, Shobu perfectly evokes a strategic experience that does absolutely nothing to get in its own way. The rules are light while still being complex, and you don't have much to keep in your head. The aforementioned strategy lock as you hover over the board trying to find the optimal move is evidence that there's actually a pretty serious game here. Shobu is vying for shelf space with some really great two-player games, and I believe earns its spot due to the simplicity on the table as well as the enormously elegant presence there. Let's go through our checklist. In the box, rulebook clear and non-gender pronouns. The rulebook is just a single sheet of paper folded in half, and 1/4 of that entire space is dedicated to a quick look player guide. The game's simple rule set is easily imparted, and there are even full color examples to clarify this further. It refers to you as either the player or by the color of your stones throughout. iconography clear. There's no iconography in the game whatsoever. You're just moving stones around. Packaging well done. The box holds the four boards and the insert pretty well, and there's a side channel for the stones and the 100% useless but pretty rope. Shobu can be stored on its side with no worries about pieces falling all over the place. On the table, good representation. Being an abstract strategy game, there's no representation to be had. One of the reasons I like games like this so very much. Component quality, outstanding. The four-player boards are a solid wood of good thickness, the stones are good-sized polished river stones, and they're not mass-produced. Each has its own shape and quirks, another compelling feature of this game. One thing to note, my copy of Shobu came with only 15 black stones, one shy of what's needed to play. I was able to find a suitable replacement in my yard, oddly enough, but after contacting Smirk and Laughter immediately and being told a replacement was coming, I haven't seen it as of the time of this recording. Replay value, immensely high. With very few movement rules and four boards to play on, someone mathier than me can come up with how many different possibilities there are. It's a pretty high number. Fun to lose, very much so. Since you only lose when all your stones are removed from one board, it's very possible that you and your opponent begin to focus on different boards once the game gets into a full swing. Nearly every game of Shobu I've played in preparation for this review has been close. As I mentioned before, the usual refrain of, oh, I got it halfway through, but by then it was too late, can be overcome here, so that's a huge selling feature. Shobu has the feel of a classic game as soon as you take it out of the box, and the more you play it, the more you start to realize that the game's simple rule set is a huge asset rather than a liability. If the rule is do more with less, then Smirk and Laughter have done a massive amount here. I highly recommend this game if you're into games like Go or chess, as Shobu can be taught faster and plays quicker than both. I'm Nicholas, reminding you to help protect the game population, always sleeve your cards, or just turn them into rocks. That works as well. Hey everyone, if you enjoyed that video, please hit that sub button and check out all of our other offerings at goodluckhighfive.com. And please consider becoming a patron of the channel at patreon.com/glhfmagic and help us keep making reviews, videos, and podcasts for as little as $5 a month. We're also always looking for new games to review, so if you make games or you know a company who does and wants to have their game reviewed on Good Luck High Five, please reach out to us at glhf@goodluckhighfive.com and we'd be happy to take a look. You can follow me, Captain N the Game Master, on Twitter and Instagram at CaptainNGM, and follow the channel at GLHFMagic. Remember, please shop at your local game store whenever possible. Until next time, I'm Nicholas, and good luck, high five.